This conference will now be recorded.
Hi everyone. Welcome to KKR Coders YouTube channel, JavaScript tutorials. My name is Kusu Sinwas. In this video, I am going to discuss about if statement. Already in the last video, if statement part one, if statement part one video, we are discussing simple if statement. Already discussed simple if statement and if else statement. Four types of if statements are available in JavaScript. One is a simple if statement, and the second one is if else statement, and the third one is if else if statement. This is third one is if else if statement, and the fourth one is nested if statement. Already these two statements are explained in if statement part one video. In this video, we are discussing third statement, that is if else if statement. In this statement, we are using actually the real if statement is if else statement is real if else syntax is if else syntax is syntax is if condition the condition encloses the parentheses. And for example, this is a statement one. Statement one only. And else part, beginning of the else part, and another statement. This is only for simple if else statement. Only if else only. If else part only. This is if else part. If else part. If the condition returns true, if this condition returns true value. This condition returns true value. Statement one will be executed. Otherwise, statement two will be executed. But we are discussing third type. The third type is the third one is if else elif statement. Again, else part. We are using another if statement, and another condition. If else elif. If else if statement. If this condition returns true, this flag will be executed. Again, one more else, beginning of the else, beginning passes of the else part, and here, statement three. Please observe this one. Okay, here, there are the different conditions. We are using three conditions. Condition, this is called as a condition one. And this is called a condition two. Here, if is a keyword and else is a keyword. In this syntax, here, the first one is if else are keywords in JavaScript. These two are the keywords. Okay, then what happens are in this condition, if the condition one returns true, statement one will be executed. The remaining part are not executed. Else if part is completely not executed. The total remaining part is not executed. If the condition one returns true, then statement one will be executed, and remaining part not executed. Please observe this point. Remaining part is not executed. This condition returns true, statement one will be executed, the remaining part is not executed, only when the condition returns true. If the condition returns false, if condition one returns false, then what happens? If the condition one returns false, statement one is not executed. Statement one is not executed. statement one is not executed. And to test or to check condition two. To check the condition two. Please observe this point, very important. This condition returns false. This is not executed. And check condition two. Condition two is checking. Condition two is checking. Again, the condition two also returns either true value or false value. If condition two returns true, then the condition returns true, then what happens? Then statement two will be executed. Statement two will be executed. Okay. And the remaining part is not executed. And remaining part not executed. Two is executed and the remaining part is not executed. If the condition two returns false, then statement three will be executed. Mainly it is used to, mainly if else elif is used to, it is used to check multiple conditions. Here observe, condition one checking and condition two also checking. Based on the condition one and two, condition one true, statement one is executed. The remaining part is not executed. If the condition one false, condition two is checking, it is true, statement two is executed, then statement three will be okay, not executed. If this condition returns false, two is not executed and the three is executed. Simple example program, here we are discussing only if else elif part. For example, to find the given number is positive number or negative. The given number is positive number or negative number or zero number. To find the given number is positive number or negative number or zero number. Enter a number. Given number is, for example, you have entered a number is 89. 89 is a positive number. For example, you have entered a number is minus 45. That is a zero, minus negative number. That equal to zero is a zero number. Check the number. If n value is greater than zero, first condition, checking first condition. If n value is greater than zero, begin curly braces, document dot write off given number is positive number. Given number is positive number. And end of this problem. Else again if condition is n value is less than zero. Now argument dot write off given number is negative number. Check the condition. Else part. We're also using else part. Argument dot write off given number is zero number. Clear? This is the program, right? Logic the program. For example, this is n value. Here the n value is 8. For example, the n value is 8. N value is 8. 8 is greater than 0. This condition returns true value or false value. True or false. Here this condition returns true value. This condition returns true. Then immediately this block will be executed. Given number is positive number. The remaining block is not executed. For example, your entered number is minus 3. And n value is minus 3. Minus 3 is greater than 0. This condition returns a false value. So this is not executed. Check the second condition. The second condition is minus 3 is less than 0. N value is minus 3. Your entered n value is minus 3. Minus 3 is less than 0. this condition returns true, then only immediately execute the given number is negative number. This statement will be executed. This is not executed. For example, your entered value is zero. Your entered value n value is your entered value is zero. For example, n value is zero. Zero is greater than zero. False. Again, n value is less than zero. Zero is less than zero. Zero is less than zero. This condition also returns false. First condition returns false, and the second condition also returns false. Both the conditions are returns false value. Then execute this else black. Given number is negative number. Okay, guys, are clear? Clear all of you? Now go to the programming one. The same one written in the program. Right, write the logic. The logic, enter the value. This entire block will be written in by using the script tag. By using the script tag. Script tag and script tag and script tag. Okay. Now here enter the n value. N value variable and n is a variable. N equal to enter the value from the keyboard by using prompt command or by using any input tag by HTML tag. Anyone is possible by using the prompt enter any number. Enter the number by using from the keyboard. Okay, now we are using each and every line end with semicolon. Okay. Now the first value, if n value is greater than zero, execute this statement. Else if less than zero, execute this statement. Otherwise, execute this block. Okay, clear up here? Now save the value, save the program, and run them up, run the program. Okay, this is the value. Enter any number. It is a one command prompt. It is a one dialog box. Your entered number is 8. Okay. Now given number is positive number. Okay, clear guys, up to here. For example, enter one more time and run the one more time. Run the module. For example, run the enter value. For example, zero. Enter any number. Your entered value is zero. Zero is less than zero. False. Zero is greater than zero. False. Automatically execute. Your number is zero number. Okay. For example, this same program running one more time. Enter the elif part. Else if, for example, you enter the value is minus 34. Now you enter the number is negative number. Guys, clear up to here? This is the third statement. The third part, that is a if else elif statement. And the next one is very important one is nested if statement. Now what is nested if statement? The fourth one is nested if statement. What is nested if? Nested if statement means, nested if statement means simple, in simple, very simple. What is if statement? If condition is present, this is a condition. Okay. Now this is a condition. Okay, this is a condition, simple. And else part. This is the else part, right? Any one statement. Yeah. This is the if part, and this block will be called as a else part. An if statement contains another if statement. For example, here it contains if condition. Again, the beginning of the if here it is statement one, and else. Else, this is the begin part, and this is the statement two. Again, we're executing the beginning and ending. Okay, again this part, statement three. Here, please observe this point. Okay, a if statement. It is an if statement. This is completely if statement. This block will be completely if statement block. A if statement contains another if statement. A if statement contains another if statement, innerly another if statement. So this is called as a outer if statement. This is called as a outer if statement. And this statement will be called as a inner if statement. Inner if statement. First check this condition. If it is true, enter into the inner if statement. If it is false, automatically directly statement 3 will be executed. Clear guys, up to here all of you. Now, the syntax. Okay, go to the syntax. What is nested if statement? A A if statement contains another if statement. Another if statement. It is called a nested if statement. If statement contains another if statement, it is called a nested if statement. This is the complete syntax of if statement. This is a complete syntax of the if statement. This is a condition one. This is condition one. Condition one. Again, this is condition two. Condition two. Condition one true. Condition two is true. Then statement one will be executed. Here. Condition one returns true. Condition one returns true. And condition two returns true. Returns true. Both conditions returns true. Condition one returns true. Condition two returns true. Then statement one will be executed. Statement one will be executed. Will be executed. And for example, condition one returns true. Condition one returns true. Returns true. Returns true. And condition two returns false. Returns false. Then statement two will be executed. Statement two will be executed. Executed. Please observe this one. And third one. If condition one returns false, condition one returns false, then directly statement three will be executed. Statement three will be executed. Clear? And if statement contains another if statement. If this is condition, this condition returns true, this will be executed. Okay. This condition one returns true, and check the condition two. If it is true, execute this one. Otherwise this one. Now execute the same program. Example program using if statement, using nested if. Write a program. To check the given number is positive number or negative number or zero number using or zero number using nested if statement. What is the nested if statement? Take the if statement contains another if statement. It is a nested if statement. If condition n value is greater than or equal to zero, this is the first condition. Is greater than or equal to zero, beginning of the first condition and ending, and else part beginning and ending. This is the basic if else. Okay, clear? And argument dot write of given number is zero number. Directly else part, you are writing the else part. Given number is zero number and the semicolon and the rest. If n is greater than or equal to zero, it is a if statement. In this if statement, you are writing another if statement. Another if statement means if n is greater than zero, check the condition. If n is greater than zero, now we are writing document dot write of given number is positive number, check the value, and else what document dot write of given number is zero number. Okay, clear? And here after we are writing, if the first condition is true, then execute this one. Otherwise, given number is negative number. To find the given number is negative number or positive number, negative number, using nested if statement. What is nested if statement? A if statement contains another if statement. It is called as a nested if statement. Now we are checking first condition. For example, your entered number equal to 8. For example, the n value is 8. Check it either positive or negative or zero. Here check the condition. 8 is greater than or equal to 0. This condition returns a true value. Okay, guys, clear? This condition returns true. Again, the check enter into this condition returns true. Then this part will be executed. Again, this is the if part. This part will be executed. 8 greater than 0. This condition is true. Again, check the second condition. 8 is greater than 0. Less greater than or equal to 0 or greater than 0. Now this condition is returns true. Now this part will be executed. For example, the n value is, for example, the n value equal to 0. For example, the n value equal to 0. Here 0 is greater than or equal to 0. This condition returns true. This condition returns true. So 0 is greater than 0. This condition returns false. Then immediately execute this one. Your number is 0 now. Clear, guys? Up to you. Next, for example, your entire number equal to n value is minus 8. Here, check the condition, first condition. Minus 8 is greater than or equal to 0. This condition returns false. First condition returns false. So now immediately this block is not executed. Because this condition returns false, execute this else part. Given number is negative number, the output is. Clear up to here, all of you guys? Now run this module. Run this module here, check it. Okay. Save the program. Any mistake? Enter n value, prompt value, first condition, all the semicolons, everything is final. Now run the module. Or enter the number 8. Click it. Your number is positive number. Okay, done. Using nested if statement. Run one more time using another value. Your entire number is, for example, 0. The output is 0 number. For example, run one more time using negative number. Run the value. For example, your entire number is minus 90. Right? Your entire number is negative number. Okay, guys, up to here, clear all of you? Thanks for watching this video. If you want to watch more videos, please subscribe. Subscribe the KKR Coders, KKR Coders YouTube channel. Watch for more videos on Python, C language videos, Python videos, C++ videos, JavaScript videos, AWS videos, and DevOps videos for coming few days. Okay, thanks for watching this video.